In this video, we are going to solve question based on Francis turbine, where we will calculate rate of flow, guide blade angle, inner and outer diameters of runner, and runner blade angle at inlet of Francis turbine. So here is the statement. The following data is given for Francis turbine, where net head is 70 meter, speed equal to 700 rpm, shaft power is 330 kW, overall efficiency of turbine is 85%. Hydraulic efficiency is 92%, flow ratio equal to 0.22, breadth ratio equal to 0.1, the outer diameter of runner is twice of inner diameter of runner, and the thickness of vane occupies 6% of circumferential area of runner, and the velocity of flow is constant at inlet, and discharge is radial at outlet. Determine rate of flow, guide blade angle, inner and outer diameter of runner, runner vane angle at inlet. Now let's write down what all is given in our question. So we are given the net head capital H as 70 meter. The capital N is given as 700 rpm. Shaft power equal to 330 kW. The overall efficiency is 0.85 and hydraulic efficiency is 0.92. The flow ratio represented as Kf is given as 0.22 and breadth ratio is 0.1. And outer diameter D1 equal to twice of inner diameter, that is D2. Here thickness of vanes occupy area is 6% of circumferential area of runner, that means 0.06 by D1 B1, and here velocity of flow is constant, means VF1 is equal to VF2. So since it is specified in our question that discharge is radial at outlet, that is angle beta is 90 degree, hence VW2 will be 0. So first we need to find out rate of flow, which we denote as capital Q. As we studied in previous video, we know the formula for overall efficiency, which is equal to shaft power by input power, where input power is rho GQH, and in that we need to find out value of capital Q, that is rate of flow. And here we know the value of shaft power, net head capital H, density of water rho is 1000, and acceleration due to gravity small g is 9.81. So we can substitute all these values and solve for the value of rate of flow to be 0.5654 meter cube per second. Next we need to find out guide blade angle alpha. Now let's look at the figure. Consider the turbine blade as shown in figure, where alpha is angle made by absolute velocity of jet, that is V1 at inlet. That means to find guide blade angle alpha, we take inlet velocity angle from the given figure. So as we have studied in previous video, that from inlet velocity angle, the tan alpha is opposite side by adjacent side, where opposite side is VF1 and adjacent side is VW1. But here we don't know the values of VF1 and VW1. So here first we need to find out these values in order to calculate guide blade angle alpha. And in question, the value of flow ratio is given as 0.22. So we know the formula, where value of Kf we have already given in question, and capital H also given in question. Here small g, acceleration due to gravity, is 9.81. So we can substitute all these values and solve for the value of VF1. Now to find out values of VW1, I will use equation of hydraulic efficiency, which is equal to VW1 multiplied by U1 whole term divided by small g into h. Here we don't know u1, that is tangential velocity at inlet, and tangential velocity which can be determined by formula, that is pi d1n by 60, where speed capital N is 700 rpm and d1 is outer diameter of runner, which we need to calculate by discharge equation, where discharge capital Q equal to net area flow multiplied by vf1. Here since we have found the value of vf1, we can substitute VF1. And here in the question, they have mentioned that thickness of vane occupy 6% of circumferential area of runner, so that net area of flow it will becomes pi d1 b1 minus 0.06 pi d1 b1. And here by using breadth ratio given as 0.1, that p1 by d1, I will write p1 in terms of d1. And by calculating this whole term, we will get the value of d1, that is outer diameter of runner, as 0.4846. And with the help of D1, I will calculate tangential velocity at inlet, that is U1, as 17.76 meter per second. And I'll substitute this value in equation of hydraulic efficiency. And from here, we will get VW1 as 35.57 meter per second. So in this way, we found the values of VF1 and VW1, and I'll substitute these values. And by taking of tan inverse, we solve for the value of guide blade angle alpha to be 12.91 degree. The next we need to calculate inner diameter D2 and outer diameter D1 of runner. And we have found outer diameter D1 as 0.4846 meter. And in question, it is specified that outer diameter D1 equal to twice the inner diameter of runner, that is D2. So that inner diameter of runner D2 we got as 0.2423 meter. Now next we need to calculate runner vane angle at inlet, that is theta. So to find out this angle, we take inlet velocity angle from the given figure. So as we have studied in previous video, from inlet velocity angle, the tan theta is opposite side by adjacent side, where opposite side is VF1 and here adjacent side is VW1 minus U1. So here we have found all these values in order to get angle theta. Therefore, by taking tan inverse, we'll get runner vane angle at inlet, that is theta equal to 24.6 degree.